I let him, you know, do it with me because he said he'd help me thump the freak. He had me cornered anyway. I didn't think he'd go that far. Now I just don't know what to do.
You better move, love. We'll be dumping a ton of stuff here in a minute. You all right, lady? Hey, Blue, get over here.
What's up?
Something the matter with her. She's in a trance or something. Come on, love, snap out of it. Yeah, that's enough.
Feeling all right, love?
Yes. What is this place?
Number 5. There's a passenger ship on board. Is that what you wanted?
Me so much back rent for Driscoll House in 5 years' time, I'll be worth a fortune.
Why 5 years?
That's when I'm getting out.
Oh, well, why sell it? You're going to need somewhere to live.
No, Myra, I'm sorry. I am taking that bitch to court. Anyway, Driscoll stopped being my home the day Hazel died. I couldn't go back there.
She didn't die. She was murdered, remember?
A couple of days, I'll sign the papers and Driscoll will not be my worries anymore.
I just spoke to Mum. Guess what?
Well, you're telling the story.
She's having that wedding dress made in another size.
Isn't the wedding the day after tomorrow?
Yeah, so?
Well, making a wedding dress isn't the same as an ordinary frock.
Ray, but if they haven't got it in stock, you're not going to get it in time.
Well, don't tell me that!
Marlene, Governor wants
to see
you.
How long does it take to make a wedding dress?
Oh, one person, full time, about a week, I suppose.
Oh, my God, what am I going to do?
Right now, you're going to see the Governor, so come on.
What about 6 people? Oh, why did I go off the diet?
I thought I had problems.
Well, her mum will sort it out for her only daughter. Come on, let's get back to work. We need another pickup. Sorry, Anita, it's your turn.
Oh, don't worry, I'll do it.
No, it's all right, Lizzie. I can do it.
What is all that about?
I don't know. The kids hardly said a word all morning.
Yes, all right, all right, but we'll talk about it later. Come on in.
Morning, Mrs. R.
Sit down, honey.
This isn't about the wedding, is it? Because if it's more bad news, I'm just going to chuck the whole thing in.
Well, yes, it is, but it's good news. The first of your wedding presents, really.
Oh, yeah? Who from?
The department. This is the authorization for your release. You'll be leaving us tomorrow.
They can't. They can't. I'm getting married. They know that.
But surely this is better. The only difference is you'll be arriving in a car.
Oh, yeah, but the girls were going to help me get ready and everything. It won't be the same if I'm on the outside. Please, Mrs. Reynolds, do something to stop it.
I can't do that. The form's here and it's signed.
Do they know you've got it?
Of course they do.
Well, how do they know? Did they hand it to you personally?
Well, no, it came with a lot of other departmental mail.
Well, there you are then. You can say it got lost. Please, Mrs. Reynolds.
I give up. I really do. I thought you'd be pleased.
Please, my whole bloody wedding's
out. All right, all right. Wait outside for a minute. I want to speak to Mrs. Barry. Do you think we'd have trouble with the other women if she is released before the wedding?
Yes, I think so. It's as much their wedding as it is hers, really.
All right, bring her back in.
What do you say? Get this inside and have a beer, eh?
I don't want to argue with that.
Excuse me, mate.
Yep.
About the other day. Hope you don't think I was getting stuck into you along with the others.
Oh, aye, just looking on, were you?
I said to Bernie, he's the one with the Foster's goiter. I said, wake up to yourself, son. What would the old dentist be doing knocking off kids when he's got a prison full of goers to keep him busy? He said, And if you ever want to take on an extra man, well, just give him a yell.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and you can do me a favour if you would, too.
Oh, well, seeing as though you stuck up for me like that, I don't have much choice, do I?
Yeah, well, perhaps you'd write something funny under this picture here, you see me?
Just sod off, will you?
Hey?
You heard me, sod off or I'll flatten you.
And if he doesn't, I will, mate.
Dennis!
Okay, okay. The fella tries to do the right thing. Bloody Pom.
Good morning, Miss Ferguson.
Sister,
are you all right? I thought they would have given you the day off after yesterday's incident.
Oh, no, I'm all right. It takes more than a bump on the head to put me out of action.
Glad to hear it.
I suppose there was quite a bit of celebrating in the rec room when they all heard.
I wouldn't know. It's not for me to judge.
Sorry. Sister, I want to thank you for our little chat the other day. It helped.
How'd you get on?
What?
With Rena, what'd she want?
Nothing. She just wanted to tell me something.
Oh, what the hell sort of answer is that?
Well, it was private, all right?
All right, that's all you had to say in the first place.
Okay. Hey, you didn't see Anita, did you?
Oh, why?
It doesn't matter.
Cut the whispering, you two.
Jeez, can't you have any secrets now?
What the hell is the matter with you? Did Reno have a go at you for something?
No. She just wanted to tell me something about the wedding, that's all.
Still wasting time with the girly talk, are we, eh? Chatting about weddings when you should be working.
Yeah, we were just taking bits on what you was going to wear.
Again, Kelly? I didn't quite...
Miss Ferguson?
Either she was pulling a shifty. Fucking if I know what she's up to.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. When morning comes around.